it's not as simple as number one, replacing all the lead pipes and the problem goes away. We've proven that here today. You still have a threat of lead in water even if you don't have lead pipe. The second thing that we thought going in is it's going to be hard to find the lead pipe because we know how bad the records are usually across the United States. But it's even harder than we thought. So what we're looking at, it becomes then a scientific question then, because if you want to solve the lead problem, you know, the question is how much of this is lead pipe, how much of it is brass, galvanized iron, and the lead solder.
I think it's great. I really do. Yeah, because if it wouldn't have been for Virginia Tech, I wouldn't have known I had lead in my water.
I've heard a bit about Flint and the whole crisis and everything that's been going on out here from my dad and from the news, but I hadn't really gotten an actual feel or understanding of what's going on out here and the issues that the people have been facing until I got here. And we drove around and we looked at the houses and we looked at the water, and it kind of really set home as something needs to be done here.
I've just learned how to approach problems in a different way because of this experience. And it's something that's kind of been creeping up on me throughout the whole Flint water study over the past few months. But now that I'm actually here and participating in field sampling and helping coordinate the lead kit delivery and that sampling effort is really, it's just transformative, and it really gives you a way to approach problems and talk to people about science